Hey guys, Casey here with M&R. Today we're going to be going over on how to properly expose screens for our Tri-Loc system. All right, so the things that we'll need for this is going to be our film already on carrier sheets per our last video. We're gonna need our exposure unit with our Tri-Loc master frame with pin bar already attached, and then a screen that's got emulsion on it. So before we get into actually exposing our screens, what we're gonna need to do is affix our Tri-Loc master frame to the top of our exposure unit, making sure we tape the inside of the frame so as when we insert our screens, it doesn't move at all. We're gonna want our push pins away from us and our stop blocks towards us. It's a good idea to actually move the master frame every couple of months just to make sure that we don't wear out our vacuum blanket, thus causing inconsistencies with our exposure process. Before we actually place our film on our pin bar, it's a good habit to get into of checking your glass and making sure it's clean, thus reducing the possibility of pinholes or any inconsistencies when we wash out our screen later. All right, now that we have our master frame properly installed and our glasses clean, we're gonna seat our carrier sheet completely on our pin board. We're gonna flatten out our film. And lastly, we're gonna double check to make sure that the orientation is correct, making sure if there's any text on it, you can properly read it. Or if there isn't any text, maybe reference your mock-up to make sure that everything's faced the correct way. Before inserting our screen, we're gonna need to determine what mesh count would be proper for our film. Typically, it's on the film, but if it's not, you can reference your mock-up or you can ask your art department. Next, we're gonna insert our screen. Gently pressing against our push pins, we're gonna lay the screen down completely flat and allow it to slide to hit our three stop blocks. We're gonna insert our vacuum rope to the inside of the screen, making sure it's out of the way of your image area. This is gonna give you the best vacuum seal between your film and your emulsion, and this is gonna give you a great stencil. All right guys, so prior to this process, we should have already determined what our exposure times are per our emulsion manufacturer. There's a couple of things that go into your exposure times, you know, mesh count, actual emulsion that you're using, and the stencil, how thick that emulsion is on that screen will all determine how long you're gonna have this thing in for. All right guys, so once we have determined our vacuum time and our exposure time, we'll hit start. And you can hear and you can see the vacuum working. So what we're doing is we're sucking out all of the air so we can get a nice tight seal between our screen and our film. The next thing that you'll notice is once the light turns on, it's ultraviolet light, which reacts with our light sensitive emulsion. So it's gonna harden the open area in our emulsion, and the part on our film that's black is going to stay water soluble, and that's what's actually making our stencil. So while this is exposing, you can actually take the time now to pull film and a screen for your next color that you're going to burn. Or if you have one already done, now is the time that you would walk it out to your washout booth and wash that screen out. You can also do a little dance if you want, you know, get a couple jumping jacks in. So once our exposure process is over, we're gonna just unlock the top, lift up, we're going to remove our vacuum tube and gently remove our screen, making sure that we set aside the film in a different area of our other ones to make sure that we don't burn the same one twice. Now that we've washed out our screen and we have determined that we have proper exposure time, repeat the steps for the rest of the films for the job. Thanks for joining us today. Subscribe if you haven't already. Hit that like button. Join us next time for our pre-production for our Tri-Loc setup.